very nice people. And so it's my pleasure now to welcome to the stage another one of those Olympians, and this is a young lady called Ashleigh Brennan. Result in finishing sixth. Pretty good result. Tell us firstly, if you can remember them without feeling under pressure, who was on the team with you?
So on the team we had Dasha Jura, Georgia Benora, Shona Morgan, Lauren Mitchell, Olivia Vivian, and myself.
And everybody must have pulled their weight to come in that sort of an overall position.
Definitely. I think at the time, I remember we qualified fifth, and at the end of the competition, we're like, we're fifth in the world. Like, it's pretty incredible. And to finish sixth, I think this is such a huge accomplishment for us. And yeah, the greatest result for women's gymnastics at Olympic Games. So it was definitely, yeah, a great accomplishment by the whole team.
And now for you personally in Beijing?
Personally in Beijing, I made a mistake in qualification, and I was so grateful that my coaches gave me another chance to, in team finals to get back up on the beam and give it another shot. And I was so excited that I did have another shot, on the Olympic stage. And I was so happy to come out, and hit my routines in team finals. And, I remember my last event in team finals was on floor. And floor's an apparatus that I feel really comfortable on, and I just remember my last two passes and the end of my routine, just really soaking it in and enjoying the whole moment. So it was very special.
It's also very special for us to have a group of Olympians with us tonight. This may come as a surprise. Most of us here, out of the 450 odd people that are here, have never represented Australia at the Olympics. So give us a quick insight for these people in the audience who are aspiring to become Olympians in their thing. What's it like being on an Olympic team and going to somewhere like Beijing to represent your country?
Yeah, I think, like, I remember my first competition where I represented my country was in 2004. I was 13, and so I was on the national team in Texas at the Woga Classic, and I was there with my older teammates, Burnett Russell and Steph Morehouse, and so that was really special for me to share that with those girls. And I remember how nervous I was, and I finished the competition, and I just remember thinking, gosh, I want to come back out here and wear the green and gold leotard, wear the Australian tracksuit again. So for me, that was when I really realised I wanted more of that, time and in the national team. And for an Olympic Games, I think my first memory of an Olympic Games is watching the girls prepare for the 2000 Games in Sydney. And I think I realised then and there that if I worked hard enough and if I was passionate and dedicated towards the sport, that I could achieve it as well. So in gymnastics, I think I learned that you can't set yourself, any boundaries or any limits. If you aim high, you can really achieve anything you want to. If you surround yourself with really supportive people, that will help you get there.
Just on a lighter note, Bruce reminded us earlier that in 1956, the village was divided into females on one side and men on the other, and that the women's team was so keen they put out a sign advertising pole vaulters. I have a slight suspicion that could have been instigated by Dawn Fraser, who was famous for putting out signs. Yeah. But did anything like that happen at the Beijing Olympics?
Well,
did you hang your sign out?
Definitely not. There was no there was no sort of separation, but I think,
times have changed.
They have changed, but at the same time, I think we're pretty looked after, and we're there to do our gymnastics and to not look at the boys.
Good stuff. I'd like to hear that. So tell me, go back just one last part now. Let me take you back to your very start of gymnastics, because we have kindy gym programs here too. Yep. At what age did you first walk into a gymnastics area to start any sort of gymnastics training? Give us a surprise.
I was 7.
You were 7?
Yeah. Is that
a surprise? No, I was thinking you might have been a bit younger. 7 years old?
Yeah.
Where was this?
In Berwick, so I'm from Melbourne, so about 40 minutes out from the city.
That's the part I was trying to get around to.
Yeah.
You currently train in Victoria?
Yeah.
And?
Well, I don't anymore.
You don't anymore? You've retired?
Yes, I have.
Have you?
Yeah.
Well, I think that's worth a round of applause too. Are you planning to coach?
I'm not sure. I'm doing a launch pad workshop coming up this week, so that'll be really good. I'm still, you know, busy this year and want to be involved in the sport, so hopefully, yeah, maybe one day I'll
coach. I'm doing this for a closing reason, because you have a lot of clubs here. Yep. To artistic gymnastics. And I'm quite sure if you hung your shingle out and said, I'm probably available to coach, you might have a few takers.
Well,
so maybe in the near future.
Yeah, definitely.
Ladies and gentlemen, please thank Ashleigh Brennan.
Thank you.